Welcome to ASK Tutorials. This is our C programming series. And if you have not seen our previous videos, then watch it. Link is given into the description box. We are learning loops in a C. In this video, we are going to learn about the for loop. Let's get started with the video. For loop. A for loop is a repetition control structure that allows you to efficiently write a loop that needs to execute a specific number of times. For loop can be addressed as an entry control loop. Syntax for for loop is, here we are seeing a syntax for for loop. For loop, then we open a round bracket here, then we initialization for variable here we declaring, then the condition will be given, then increment or decrement for the variable, then we are closing a round bracket here, then we are going to open a curly bracket. Inside the curly bracket we are written statement block. Here one statement will be there, also more than one statement will be there. Then we are closing a curly bracket here. This is how the syntax for the for loop. The for loop is executed as follow. It first evaluates the initialization code. Then it checks the condition expression. It will check the first initialization code, then it will check the given condition. Then if condition is a true, then it executes the for loop body. Then it evaluates the increment and decrement condition and again follows from the step 2. If condition will be true, then it will execute the for loop body. After execution, the variables will be increment or a decrement. Then again it will go from the step 2, means again the condition expression will be checked. Then when the condition expression become false, then it exits the from the loop. Now we will see the flowchart for a for loop. It will start the for loop, then the expression initialization of expression will be done, then the condition test. It will check the condition. When the condition will be true, it will execute the block of a statement inside a loop. Then it, after executing, it will update the expression. After updating an expression, again it will go to the condition test. If condition test is true, then again it will come to the block of a statement, then update the expression. This process, update expression, after updating an expression, it will again go to the condition test. This process will get continues until up to the when we'll get a condition as a false. When we'll get condition as a false, there that time it will stop the execution. It will come out of the loop. This is how the for loop works. Now we will see one program to print the first 10 natural numbers. First we declared a preprocessor command, then we declared a main function. We open a curly bracket here, then we declared a integer variable x. Then we are given here a for loop. Inside for we declared a x is equal to 1, x is a less than 10 and x plus plus. Then we open a curly bracket for a loop here. Inside a loop we are written printf statement for printing a value of a x, that is a printf percentage d slash t comma x. Then we closed a curly bracket here, we closed our for loop. Then we again once more time we closed a curly bracket for our main function. After executing this program, we will get an output as a 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. These are the 10 natural numbers we will get an output. Now we will see how this program is worked here for a for loop. We will trace now. Our condition is a for x is equal to 1, is a variable initialization here we done. Then we given condition is x is a less than equal to 10, then we are incrementing x plus plus. when first time it will go to the execution. Here condition is x is less than 10, so condition is true here because we initialized x is equal to 1, so the condition will be true. Then it will print the x value, that is a 1. Then it will x will be incremented by 1, so we will get x value as a 2. Now we got x value as a 2. When second time it will go for execution, that time again the condition will be checked, that is x is a less than equal to 10. Yes, 2 it will get a true because 2 is a less than 10, so condition is a true here. Then it will print the x value is a 2. Then it will increment x value by 1, so we'll get x is equal to 3. Again now we got x as a 3 here, so condition again we got true here, so it will print the x value is a 3. Then x will be increment by 1, so we got x as a 4 here. Then again our condition is a true because 4 is a less than equal to 10, so it will print the x value is a 4. Then x will be increment by 1, so we will get value x as a 5 here. This is how it will execute up to the 9. When we get x is equal to 9 there and x is a less than equal to 9 is true, then it will print x is a 9 and x will be increment by 1, so we will get x is equal to 10 there. And when it will go for the 10th time execution, x is a less than equal to 10, it's a true, and it will print x is a 10. Then x will be increment by 1, so we got here x is equal to 11. When 11 time it will go for execution, that time it will check the condition x is a less than equal to 10. It is false because 11 is not less than equal to 10, so condition is a false here, and it will come out of the loop and it will stop the execution. This is how we got an output for the printing a 10 natural numbers. Now we will see one more program here. Int main, in first we declared a function there. Then first we declared a preprocessor command, then we declared a main function here. Then you open a curly bracket for a main function. Inside that we declared a integer variable I is equal to 0. Then we are given condition, open a for loop. Here in a for loop we are given I is equal to 1, I is a less than equal to 10, and I plus plus. Then open a curly bracket for a for loop. And inside that we have written a statement that printf hello world, and we closed a curly bracket. Then we return 0 and we closed a curly bracket for the main function. Here in the printf statement we are written hello world, and in a condition we are given that I is less than equal to 10, so we want a output as a hello world should be print for the 10 times. This is what our output should be. When it will go for the execution, first time execution, it will check I value. First we declared I is a 0 there. In a condition we declared I is equal to 1. So it will check the condition that I is a less than equal to 10. Yes, it will true. Then it will execute the printf statement, that is a hello world, and I will be incremented by 2. Like that it will come up to the when I we will get I is equal to 10. That time it will execute the hello world here. When I will be equal to 11, that time it will stop the execution and it will come out of the loop. And it will stop the execution. We will get output for this program as a 10 times. We will get hello world, hello world, hello world as a this type of a output we will get for the this program. This is how the for loop works in a C. Thank you for watching the video.